Good evening and welcome to the Barnesville Sports Arena for tonight's matchup between the Ada Borup West basketball girls and your Barnesville Lady Trojans. We're going to turn it over to the Barnesville Pep Band for the national anthem, and we'll come back and do starting lineups. We'll get ready for the starting lineups here for the Ada Borup West.
First, the visitors on the scoreboard, the Ada Borup West Cougars. A 5'7" junior, number 4, Morgan Smart.
Number 4, Morgan Smart.
5'7" junior. Number 5, Sarah Brodzinski.
Number 5, Sarah Brodzinski, 6'1"
senior. Number 11, Isabel Markison.
Number 11, Elizabeth Markison, 5'6" senior.
Number 12, Morgan Engel,
5'11" sophomore. And number 13, Alex Tingem, 5'5" senior. The Ada Borup West Cougars, our head coach is Dave Smart. Assistant coaches Amy Johnson and Eric Smart. Starting lineups for the Barnesville Lady Trojans.
And now, the starting lineup for your Barnesville Trojans. At a guard, a 5'4" senior, Kennedy Gray.
Number 2, Kennedy Gray, 5'4" senior.
At another guard, 5'3" sophomore junior, number 4, Sophie Frederick.
Number 4, Sophie Frederick, 5'3" junior. Number 23, Abby John, 5'8" junior.
Number 24, Lexi
Haft, 5'8" junior. And number 30, Ava Fallingstead, 5'9" junior. So tonight's matchup with the Ada Borup Cougars coming in with a 17-5 overall record. They are currently in second in the Pine de Prairie South Division. They are at a 6-2 record. First place is Park Christian Girls, I believe, in that conference. And for the Barnesville Lady Trojans, come in with an overall record of 15-8. They are currently third in the HOL with a 7-4 conference record, behind both Perm and Pelican Rapids, which are they're both sitting at 10-2. So the Cougars win the tip. Got a steal by Abby John. She's going coast to coast for the layup and the finish. Abby John with the steal and the finish for the Trojans, put them on the scoreboard. here early in the matchup between the Cougars and the Trojans. That shot was by number 5, Sarah Przinski. Rebound to Abby John. Abby John's looking to push. She's looking to kick it out over there to Sophia Frederick, knocked out of bounds. By number 11, Markison. So Trojans will inbounds here. Kennedy Gray. Kennedy gets it into Abby John. Looks like a little bit of a 1-2-2 zone, if not a 3-2 zone by the Cougars. They have a falling set at the top. Abby John from 22. That one looks short. Rebound to Morgan Smart. Bringing the ball up for the Cougars. Over to Tinjum. Tinjum up to Przinski. Przinski over to Smart. They're looking to get the ball early inside. They do have a little bit of a height advantage. Smart with the drive there. A little long. Rebound Trojans. Abby John looking to push. Gets it over to Lexi Hay. Back over to Abby John. Looking to set up the offense. Now it looks like they're in a little bit of a man-to-man. Man-to-man. Ava Fallingstead inside the post. 2 for Ava Fallingstead. That gives the Trojans a 4-0 lead here with 16:30 to go here in the first half. Markison with the drive and the foul and the finish. Nice drive there by Isabel Markison. 5'6 senior. She gets the layup to go, and she will go to the free throw line to finish the traditional three-point play. Foul is on, I believe that was Kennedy Gray. That'll be her first. And Isabel Markison finishes the three-point play. So 4-3, Trojans over the Cougars. Trojans looking inside to Ava. That one's just a little long. Ava did have post position there, but pass was just a little bit too long. I think what you're seeing here from both teams, they want to get the ball inside. Cougars have a little bit of a height advantage over the Trojans, and so what I've noticed the last couple trips down for the Cougars is they're looking inside just right there, getting the pass over to Lexi Haft. Good finish there by number 12, Morgan Engel. So it'll be interesting to see how this game plays out with the height advantage that the Cougars have over the Trojans, and if they continue to look inside and what's going to happen, change defensively for the Barnesville Trojans with that height advantage that the Cougars have. So 5-4 Cougars over the Trojans. Sophia Frederick looking up to Abby John. Abby John at the top of the key, kicks it back over to Sophia Frederick. Up to Ava Fallingstead, over same spot. Abby John was a little short last time, a little long this time. That'll be out of bounds on the Trojans. Over to the Cougars. I think you're seeing the Cougars are laying off a little bit, looking to maybe sag inside a little bit on the Trojans. There's a couple outside shots there by Abby John. She wasn't able to connect. So we'll see if that changes Coach Bomstead's offense here as things play out here as we're early into the first half. So Alex Tinjum over to Przinski. Przinski picks up her dribble. Ava Fallingstead with good defense. Sophia Frederick with the knockaway. Looks like Sophia just stepped on the line after that steal, but good defense by Ava Fallingstead there, getting the offensive player to pick up the dribble there. She was in a tough spot, tried to kick it out. Sophia Frederick with a good step in there, and she knocks the ball away here too. So she's reading those passes, those bounce passes that the Cougars are looking to get, whether it's inbounds or when they pick up their dribble. So good couple defense possessions there by Sophia Frederick getting her hands on the ball. So 5-4, Cougars over the Trojans with 14:53 here in the first half. Engel with it. Over to Markison. Markison for 3. That one's a little long. Abby John with the rebound. Looking to push. She's going to penetrate. Kicks it out to Lexi Haft. She kicks it over to Kennedy Gray. Kennedy Gray with the penetration and the 2-point layup. Good recognition of defense there by Kennedy Gray, where she had her defender a little off balance there on her side and was able to get drive to the basket and finish there for 2 points. So 6-5 Trojans over the Cougars with 14:15 left to go here in the first half. Tinjum with the ball at the top of the key. Over to Markison. Markison, that 3 is good. 3-pointer is good from the left wing. Nice looking shot there by Isabel Markison. Again, that's the second time that the Trojans have tried to get a lob pass in with Ava Fallingstead with the defender in front of her. And It's one of those things where those passes can be a little bit challenging unless you get a little bit more air underneath it. If it's a little bit of a line drive pass, it's a little hard for the offensive player to go get it. And so what I'd like to see is if Ava can, if she puts her hand up for a target for those passes in, it'll be a little bit easier for those passes to come in from the wing. So Cougar basket by number 12, Morgan Engel. That gives the Cougars a 10-6 lead here. Trojans looking to set up in their offense. Again, another high pass post into the post for Ava Fallingstead. That was a nice pass from the top of the key from Abby John into Ava for two. Again, Cougars looking to front their post, maybe use their height advantage a little bit. Abby John with the half-court steal. She's looking to do her step through, her patented step through, and that one's good for two. Two more for Abby John. That gives her four here early in the first half for the Trojans. The game is tied 10-10 with 13:08 left to go here in the first. Engel kicks it out to Smart. Smart over to Tingem. Back into Markison. Markison kicks it out to Brzezinski. That one's a little long. Rebound to John. There's that step through. Abby John finishes again for two. Again, if Abby John gets a step on that in the full court, she's going to take it, go all the way, especially gets one-on-one defense, a defender right in front of her. And so great couple finishes back-to-back for Abby John, who now has 6 points for the Trojans. So, Abby looking to go for another steal. Sophia gets her hand on another. Knocks that one away. Looks like we got a foul underneath on the Trojans. That foul will be on, it looks like, Lexi Haft, which will be her first. Team's second foul. We got three Trojans checking in. Number 15, Macy Pana. 14, Annika Cassette. And number 22, Auburn Hins, check in for the Trojans. So looks like we've got a little bit of a short box set here from the Cougars on their out of bounds. Smart looking to kick it in. That one's knocked away by Abby John. Looks to kick it over. She was looking for Pana there on the fast break. There was a two-on-one. Got knocked away. Ball ends up back in Ava Fallingstead's hands. And then that 12-foot jump shot, she got fouled on it. So she's going to go to the line to shoot two for the Trojans. Looks like that foul was on number 22, Severson, 6'3 sophomore. So one more for the junior, Ava Fallingstead. That one's up and good. That gives the Trojans a 14-10 lead with 12:22 left in the first half. That one's knocked away by Abby John. Ava Fallingstead picks it up. It's a little bit of a floater. Nice little floater there by Ava Fallingstead on the after the steal in the finish for Ava Fallingstead. She's got 8 quick points here for the Trojans in the first half. We've got less than 12 minutes to go here in the first half, with the Trojans 16, Cougars 10. Looks like a travel there on Engel. Slid her foot there once she got the ball in the post to look to shoot. That'll be turnover on the Cougars. So 11:52 left here in the first half. Trojans 16, Cougars 10. Abby John looking, bringing the ball up. Kicks it over to Cassette. Cassette up to Hins. Hins look to kick it over to Cassette. She was looking to cut. Turnover on the Trojans. It'll go back to the Cougars. Again, Cougars coming in with a nice record of 17-5 in second place in their conference. Number 35, Engelstead, 5'11 junior, checked in for the Cougars. Offensive foul there on Morgan Smart for the Cougars. That is her first, team second. Gets the ball back to the Trojans. Abby John kicks it over to Cassette. Hands over to Abby John, who's looking to penetrate. Good, strong finish. Got Cougar had a defense, had their hand on that basketball there, and Abby John was able to at least still get it up there and finish for the layup. And Abby John has 8 points. So between her and Fallingstead, They have 16 of the 18 here with 11 minutes left to go in the first half. High pass in to number 35, Engelstead. She had good position on the defender there, just a little bit long on her layup. Now Abby John kicks it over to Pana. Pana up to Abby John. Abby John sets her feet. Up a little bit short. Good battle for the rebound there by Annika Cassette. Gets it back to the Trojans. Shot clock resets to 20. Auburn Hens at the top to Abby John. Looking again, I think the Trojans are looking to get the ball in on a high there. Number 14, Cassette for the three. It's a little long. Cougars get the rebound. They were looking to push. Now they'll slow it up and set up in their half-court offense. Severson on the wing. Up to Engelstead. Engelstead kicks it over to Tinjum. Again, you can hear Coach Bomstead in the background with help side. As again, Cougars have a height advantage. Ava Fallingstead running the floor. I think that's the right idea on that fast break by Cassette to look up as Ava Fallingstead was running the floor. And the pass led her just a tish too far underneath the basket, and her right foot stepped out of bounds, so there'll be a turnover on the Trojans. So we have number 11, Markison, checking back in for the Cougars, and Lexi Hafe checking in for Ava Fallingstead with 9:50 left to go in the first half. Trojans 18, Cougars 10. Markison on the wing, kicks it up to Smart. Smart over to Engelstead. Engelstead looking for a cutter. Back up to Engel. Engel looking to drive. Gets it stolen by Auburn Hens. They have a 3-on-2. Looks like Auburn Hens is going to take it all the way, which is the right idea. The defender kind of sagged off to the right there on that fast break, and Auburn read that defender kicking over to the right there, and Auburn Hens, having a high basketball IQ, stepped right through that and went in for the layup for two. So with 9:24 left here in the first half, you got Trojans 20, Cougars 10. We have a quick 30-second timeout by the Cougars. So while we have this quick timeout, I'd like to thank our sponsors for that allow us to bring you this live stream. It's Lee's Electric, Ratso's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Walgreen Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnesville Grocery, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. I think you notice we're not quite halfway through this first half, and the Lady Trojans, who often, I know Coach Bomstead likes to have them push if they can, they're getting a rebound and they're pushing that ball up there, and I'd like to think that they have probably half their points on fast breaks. And boy, when you can do that, that sure puts a lot of pressure on the defense to make sure they're getting back. Number 11, Markison with the corner three. That one just in and out. Lexi Hafe running the floor. Great pass by Abby John to lead her to that corner block spot. Good use of the backboard, Lexi Hafe, with her first 2 points of the game. So 22-10. Trojans, another turnover. Cassette got her hand on that one, stole it. Over to Abby John, again looking to penetrate. That one's a little long. Lexi Hafe with the offensive rebound. Tries to put that one back, gets fouled. So foul will be on number four, Morgan Smart. That's her second, team's third. Lexi Hape will go to the line to shoot two for the Trojans. Their first one's up, that one's short. That's a couple substitutions in. Number five, Sarah Prozinski. And number two for the Trojans, Kennedy Gray. And number 30, Ava Fallingstead, check in for the Trojans. So, second and two for Lexi Haft. That one is good. There's one for two at the free throw line. 23-10, Trojans over the Cougars with 8:38 left here in the first half. Barnesville doing a good job on defense, only holding the Cougars right now to 10 points. Getting their, knocking ball away a few times, getting some steals. So Coach Bomstead has them playing real solid defense right now. So they're having a little bit of a hard time getting the ball inside. So whatever adjustments that Bomstead made from early in the game when they were looking to get the ball in, they're doing the right thing right now. So that one's off a little bit by Engel. Offensive rebound. Engel's going to shoot a three. That one Rebound. That one was off. Rebound over to Fallingstead. Trojans look to bring it up. Hanna kicks it up to Haft. Haft over to Cassette. Cassette looking inside. Good defense there by number 12, Engel. Engel gets the ball up to number 11, Marcus Hinn, who finishes for two. That probably is a 3.5 minute drought there that's just broken there by the Cougars. They were on 10 for quite a while. So 23-12, Trojans over the Cougars with 7:30 left here in the first half. So Cassette up to Gray. Gray over to Pana. Inside to Haft, who kicks it. I think she was looking for an offensive player to be in there on that other side, which would have been open, but no one was there. And so Kennedy Gray with the turnover. Number 12, Morgan Engel, gets the steal and the basket. 2 points for the Cougars. Morgan Engel has six for the Cougars. So Cassette on the wing, up to Gray. Gray over to Pana. Pana looking inside. Nothing there. Haft at the top. Kicks it over to Pana. Pana with a little bit of a floater off the backboard. Rebound by Engelstead. Markson bringing the ball up, looking to set up the half-court offense. Over to 22, Severson. Severson looking inside. Kicks it over to Markson. Markson at the top of the key. Dribbles over to the left. Over to number 12, Engel. Looks like it'll be a travel on number 12, Engel. A turnover on the Cougars. And subbing in for the Trojans, Sophia Frederick, Auburn Hens, and Abby John for the Trojans. So 6:20 left here in the first half. Trojans 23, Cougars 14. Good back cut there by Abby John. Nice pass by Kennedy Gray there from the wing on the back cut. Set play there for the Trojans. And Abby John will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Foul will be on the Cougars, number 5, Sarah Pazinski, her first, team's fourth. Abby John with their first, that one is good. Abby John, I think, is going to go into double figures here. She makes this one with 10, that one is good. So 25-14, Trojans over the Cougars. Again, so far, Trojans doing a great job defensively, making it tough on the Cougars to get anything inside and any easy baskets. So we'll see what changes might come from the Cougars' offense here as they got a cutter there. Number 5, Brzezinski, cutting the basket. She kicks it out to Severson. Over to Markison. Markison for three from the wing. That one is good. He's got a nice-looking jump shot there. Markison with a three. She has 11 to lead the Cougars and all the scorers so far in this game. 5:30 left to go here in the first half. Trojans 25, Cougars 17. Sophia Frederick over to Gray. Gray looking inside. Severson with the knockaway. Good defense by Severson there. Knocked the ball away. Ada keeps possession of the basketball. With Abby John going coast to coast. That one's a little off. Good rebound there by Auburn Hens. Auburn Hens being in the right place at the right time as the ball came off there from Abby John, a little strong. And Auburn Hens being in the right place at the right time finishes with the offensive rebound and layup. That gives Auburn Hens 4 points for the Trojans. So 27-17, 4:50 left here in the first half. Tingen with the drive. A little hard off the backboard. Abby John, again, looking to push. Look who's up there. Ava Fallingstead running the floor so well. Couldn't quite handle that. Kicks it back out. Smart thing to do. Set up in your offense. Frederick over to Fallingstead. Fallingstead at Abby John. Looks like a nice set play for Kennedy Gray from the top for the three. That one's off to the right. Sophia Frederick over to Abby John. See if they don't post up. Yep, that's the right idea. Auburn Hens kicks it over to Abby John. 9 seconds left on the shot clock. see what Abby John here, what she has in store. Kennedy Gray kicks it out to Fallingstead. Fallingstead from 12. That one's long. Shot clock violation due to the fact that the basketball did not hit the rim, so that will be a turnover on the Trojans. Go back to the Cougars with 3:55 left here in the first half. Trojans 27, Cougars 17. Markson on the wing, looking inside. Gets the ball to Tingem. Tingem looking for a cutter there. Gets the ball to Engel at the top of the key. Kicks it over Severson in the corner. Again, they're looking to post up. Kennedy Gray with the help on the help side there, playing more midline. Again, with that height advantage that the Cougars have, it's the one thing that the Trojans are going to have to do. But good defense by Kennedy Gray there. Brzezinski for three. That one is good with the shot clock winding down. Good ball movement there by the Cougars. Got a nice open look there from three. That cuts the lead to seven here with 3:08 left in the first half. Auburn Hens kicks it over to Frederick. Frederick for three. That one looks a little long. That one's long. Knocked out of bounds by Ava Fallingstead, which will give it back over to the Cougars. So 3:02 left here in the first half. Been a fast-paced first half. There's only two team fouls for the Trojans and four for the Cougars. So refs are letting them play a little bit, getting a little bit of a flow here for the game. Good defense there by Lexi Haft as Brzezinski wanted to drive. Frederick on the right wing kicks it into Abby John. Abby John looking to penetrate. That one is going to go. And one. Foul on the Cougars. Foul's on number two, Avery Johnson, 5'2 sophomore who just checked into the game. So Abby John goes to the free throw line to convert the traditional three-point play. That one is up and short. Rebound of the Cougars. Abby John right now leading score with 12 of the 29 for the Trojans. All right, Cougars set up in their half-court offense. Johnson over to Tingem. Tingem looking to penetrate on Sophia Frederick. She's going to draw the foul. Looks like it probably is going to be on the floor, but good drive to the basket there by number 13, Alex Tingem, 5'5 senior for the Cougars. And that will be on the floor. So that'll be foul on Sophia Frederick, her first team's third. Oh, Cougars looking inside there again. Again, Cougars with a little bit of the height advantage are looking to, even if a player if the defender is fronting them, they're getting some backside help there, which you saw there. They kind of had a little bit of a midline double team there when that ball was lobbed up there, and Auburn Hens did a good job of knocking it out of bounds. So it stays with the Cougars. Avery Johnson gets it up to Tingem for three, and that one is a little long. Nice offensive rebound there by Brzezinski, 6'1", senior for the Cougars. That gets it back to seven, within seven for the Cougars, 29-22, with 1:55 left here in the first half. Oh, Abby John looking to penetrate. Nice little left-hand finish. Morgan Engel was on her hip on that penetration, and Abby John, smart thing. She had all the advantage of the offensive player with the defender on her hip and finishes with the left hand. So 31-22, Trojans over the Cougars. Tingem looks to drive. Nice little floater. Alex Tingem for two. Again, Abby John looking to push. Miss Sophia Frederick picks it back up to Abby John, looking for a screen from Lexi Haft on a roll, but just happened to, good defense by Avery Johnson there. Got knocked that ball away as they were looking to do a screen and roll with Lexi Haft and Abby John. So good defensive play there by Avery Johnson. She gets the ball knocked away, but it'll stay with the Cougars here with 1:10 left to go here in the first half. 31-24 Trojans. Oh, Engel looking to kick it over to Engelstead on the out of bounds, and that one is just a little too outside for her teammate, and that'll be turnover on the Cougars. So 7-point lead for the Trojans here with just almost 60 seconds left here in the first half. So Abby John in the left wing, she's looking to drive. Kicks it up to Lexi Haft. Over to Ava Fallingstead. Up to Sophia Frederick. Back up to Abby John. Off the one-legged runner. That's a good shot. Rebound to the Cougars. See if they go for a 2-for-1. About a 6-second difference with the shot clock and the game clock. Brzezinski from 3 from the corner. Rebound to Abby John. Looking to push. We'll see what happens here. Coach Baum said wanted him to push. That one's a little off. Abby John with her miss. Offensive rebound. Two more for Abby John. She's got 16 of the 33 here for the Trojans in the first half. So 9-point game. Under 10 seconds to go here. We'll see if the Cougars can get one. Good drive there by 35 Engelstead. 5'11 junior went baseline there. Barnesville Trojan foul will be on number 24, Lexi Haft, her second. She went up to try to block the shot there from Engelstead, so she'll go to line for two. Engelstead's first one is a little long. Severson and Markson checking in for the Cougars. Got 5.4 seconds left here on Engelstead's second free throw. That one is good. So cuts the lead down to 8 for the Trojans. 3 seconds, 2, 1. Good look there by Sophia Frederick as she was open in the corner there. So we end the first half with a Trojans 33, Ada Borup West Cougars 25. So you got two scores in double figures, one for each team. For the Trojans, you got Abby John with 16. In this first half. And for the Cougars, you have number 11, Isabel Markison, with 11. So 11 for 11. So good, strong first half. Thought it was good defense there by the Trojans, especially from the standpoint of getting rebounds and steals and looking to push. And so I would say probably half of those 33 points here in the first half were off of fast break points. And so again, a net point of emphasis that Coach Baumstead wants to do, so it'll be interesting to see how the Cougars come out here in the second half and see if they can't slow down the transition baskets that the Trojans have been having good luck with here in the first half. So right now we're going to pass it over to Sue's Dance for your halftime entertainment, and we'll come back with just a minute left before the second half starts and get you those starting lineups and get ready for the second half. So enjoy halftime.
perform their jazz routine to Women Up.
With 12 minutes to go in DGF, the boys varsity team is down 29-31. Boys are playing tonight for a chance at a share at the conference championship.
There's a minute left here to go before the second half starts here between the Trojans and the Cougars. Since we didn't have much of a break of action, I think there was only one timeout in that first half. It kind of limits us on thanking our sponsor. So I'm going to start out before the second half even starts in fear of the second half going the same way the first half did with very few breaks and neither team was in the bonus. So we'll start with thanking our sponsors that allow us to bring you this live stream into your homes. And so thank you to Lee's Electric, Ratto's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Ball Green Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnesville Grocery, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. And for those that aren't tuned in to the boys game, it's DGF and Barnesville boys at DGF tonight. And as of right now, from the activities director, Aaron Schindler, who happens to be there, because there is an opportunity for the boys to win the conference, the Heart of Lake Conference tonight. So his duties are to be there. So I'm happy to step in for Aaron Schindler here to do the live stream for you guys at home. But right now with 10:45 left, and I'm sure there's even a little bit less than that, I got this text a little bit over a minute ago from Aaron Schindler, and it's tied 34-34. So we'll keep you updated on that as I asked Schindler, Aaron Schindler, to keep me posted on that for you guys at home, because what a great opportunity for the boys to win the conference, which I believe hasn't been done since 2001 and 2002. So, all right, we missed a quick basket there by Ava Fallingstead. A good defense there by Abby John on number four, Morgan Smart. Ball went over to the Trojans, and Kenny Dre was looking to push it. She's called for the double dribble, so that'll be turnover on the Trojans here. So with Ava Fallingstead's basket, that gives the Trojans back to a double-digit lead with 17:30 left here in the second half, 35-25, Trojans over the Cougars. All right, we'll see what adjustments the Cougars made in that halftime. Nice little drive and kiss off the rim by Alex Tingem there, 5'5 senior for the Cougars. But we'll be interested to see what Coach Dave Smart for the Cougars, what adjustments they made here, both defensively and offensively here in the second half. It's always interesting to see what both teams happen to do when they're doing something well and what they aren't doing so well, and what changes the coaches do make here going into the second half. So nice little pass in there by Lexi Haft into a, again, position for Ava Fallingstead. She had number five, Sarah Prudzinski, fronting her, and it was a nice little lob pass, high-low game. And Ava Fallingstead for an easy layup. So gets it back to double figure lead for the Trojans. So Prudzinski looking to post up. Number 11, Isabel Markison, with three from the top of the key. That's, I believe, her second three tonight. She's got 14 of the 30 points for the Cougars. So 37-30 Trojans. Abby John on the left wing kicks it up to Kennedy Gray. Kennedy Gray over to Sophie Frederick. Again, another lob in to Ava Fallingstead. Again, if you noticed earlier in the game when they were trying to get the ball into Ava as the defender was fronting her, they weren't able to get the pass nearly up as high. And so they had a couple turnovers, back-to-back turnovers, trying to get the ball into Ava Fallingstead. But you can see that the pass is getting a little bit more air underneath it for Ava to catch that over the defender that's fronting her. And Ava giving up a few inches as number five, Sarah Prudzinski, is 6'1", and Ava Fallingstead is 5'9". So she's there to shoot two free throws. I believe she just missed both of those. So it's still 37-30 with 16 minutes left here in the second half. So Cougars with the ball. Again, good look there by Markison to go back-to-back with threes. That one's a little short. Rebound to Abby John. Abby John in the corner to Kennedy Gray. Back over to John. John on the right wing looking. Again, they're being patient enough where they're looking for Ava to try to get position there. Now they're looking for Haft on the post up. See if they do a high-low with Ava back into Lexi to return the favor from the nice pass that Lexi had to her early, the first pass basket for the Trojans here. So Lexi Haft with the ball fake. Looking to drive. That one gets knocked away by Prudzinski on the block on Lexi Haft's shot. So, looks like we have a foul here on the Trojans. Number 24, Lexi Haft picks up the foul. That's her third. Team's first. So gets the ball back over to the Cougars. Trojans still have a 7-point lead here. Markison on the wing. Kicks it up to Brzezinski. Brzezinski over to Tingem. Tingem looks in. Nice pass inside there to number 12, Morgan Engel. 5'11 sophomore. And just a little long. So Kennedy Gray with the penetration. A little step through. And 2 points for Kennedy Gray. That gives her four on the night for the Trojans. Great drive there by Kennedy Gray. One of the few seniors here for the Lady Trojans. So Tingem with a little bit of a jump shot. Ouch. It looks like we have a little bit of, we're going to foul there on number 5, Brzezinski. Both her and Ava were going for the rebound in the corner. And Brzezinski got a little too physical there on Ava and fouled her. That will be Sarah Brzezinski's her second foul, second team foul here in the second half. So 14:40 left in the second half. Trojans 39, Cougars 30. John over to Hins. Hins over to Gray. Gray into the corner for Abby John. Good screen there. Screen and roll there from Auburn Hins. Kick over to Kennedy Gray in the corner up to Abby John in the right wing. Just looking to penetrate. Good skip over to Sophie Frederick for three. Just off a little bit. Rebound to Morgan Smart. Morgan Smart looking up. She's got her teammate Morgan Engel, who kicks it back out to Markison. Markison back to Engel. Good little post up there. Morgan Smart for three. One short. Back up to Morgan. Tingem for three from about 21, and that one is good. Alex Tingem for three. That gives her seven tonight for the Cougars. Cuts the lead to six. Abby John.
Abby John.
With the penetration and finish for two. That gives Abby John 18 on the night so far for the Trojans with 13:35 left in the second half. So Markison on the wing. Kicks it over to Brzezinski. Brzezinski at the top of the key. Looking for a cutter. Tingem on the left wing. Looking for post up to Engel. Engel had good position there on Auburn Hins. Just couldn't finish. Rebound to the Trojans. Sophie Frederick looking to push again. Coach Bumstead wants them to push, and if nothing's there, let's pull it back out, set up our offense, as they've been able to take advantage of getting baskets inside. And so that one's blocked away by the Cougars. Number 12, Morgan Engel, out of bounds on her. It'll be Trojans ball as Cougars, number 22, Elena Severson, 6'3", sophomore, number 22. And number 35, Riel Engelstad, 5'11", junior. Oh, 20 seconds left on the shot clock. Abby John kicks it out to Frederick. Frederick knocked away there by Markison. Looking to go all the way. Misses the layup. Oop, yep. That one is a little too quick. Auburn Hins, as she was looking over to Abby John, as Abby John was out of bounds but was trying to reestablish herself inbounds and didn't quite have both feet inbounds and didn't establish position there, and that'll be turnover on the Trojans. Cougars with the ball. Kicked in to number 4, Morgan Smart with the corner 3. That one's off. It'll be foul on number 35, Engelstad, for the Cougars. As that'll be her first, team's third for the Cougars. So we have Pana and Cassette that checked in for the Trojans. Looks like we're going to have a legal screen on the Trojans there. It'll be on Ava Fallingstead, which is her first. Team second didn't quite have a set play there. And Ava just happened to move a little bit there on that screen. So it's just a legal screen. Foul on Ava, which is her first, team second here. So 12:30 left here in the second half. Trojans 41, Cougars 33. Engel with it at the top. She's looking to drive. Kicks it out to Smart. Smart looking to drive out to Severson. Severson looking for a cutter. Markson at the top from 21. That three is just a little short. It'll be out of bounds on the Trojans. It'll stay with the Cougars here. Oh, Cougars baseline out of bounds. Morgan Smart will bring the ball in. I think they're going to look at a shot clock. There's 9 seconds left here on the shot clock, and I think the refs are discussing if the shot clock should be reset. And so it's going to stay at 9. I'm not sure exactly what that conversation was, but lobbed in to number 12, Morgan Engel. That one's just a little off. Abby John looking to push. Kicks it over to Cassette. Cassette for three. That one is good for Cassette. Her first points of the game. That gives her three. So brings the lead back up for the Lady Trojans into double figures, 44-33. 11:45 left here in the second half. Looking to get the ball into Engelstead. Engel looking to drive there. She looks like she's going to be fouled there by number 14, Annika Cassette. Annika is a 5'5 sophomore. So that'll give the ball to the Cougars on the baseline out of bounds. And number 13 for the Cougars, Alex Tingem, checks in for the Cougars. So a little box set here for the Cougars. Over in the corner to Markison. Markison looking inside to Engel. Engel with a little strong on that little baseline jump shot. Auburn Hens look to pass. Took the three-point shot. Good hustle rebound by Lexi Haft. Back out to Cassette. Cassette to Pana. Pana back to Cassette, who this could be back-to-back threes. And it is back-to-back threes for Cassette, even off the backboard. So, nice shot. Good back-to-back possessions there for Annika Cassette for 2 3-pointers. So, we got a timeout on the Cougars. It'll be a 30-second timeout. And so, as you can hear, Nate Strand in the background, if you didn't hear that, just a quick update with the Trojans and the Rebels playing tonight. And again, the Trojans, this is for at least a share of the Heart of Lakes Conference title. Trojans are up 44-40 with 3:55 left. And again, we'll keep you posted on that as that game progresses. That game's obviously going to get done here before ours. So we should have a final for you guys at home once that game is complete. So again, let's thank our sponsors here as a quick 30-second timeout. Lee's Electric, Ratso's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Malgreen Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnesville Grocery, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. We thank you to those sponsors that, again, allow us to bring this live stream into your homes. Bill Severson looking inside to Engelstead. That one's knocked away. Auburn Hens looks up. Oh, good hustle there by Engelstead for the Cougars to get back in time to block the shot for Annika Cassette, who was ahead. And Auburn Hens got the ball to her. But good hustle there by Engelstead. Oh, another three-pointer by Cassette from the corner. That one's no good. Oh, back to the Cougars. Tingem looking to set up the offense over to Markison. Markison on the right wing, up to Severson. Engel on the left wing. She's looking to drive and finish off the backboard. Nice little jump shot there by Morgan Engel, 5'11 sophomore. Abby John penetrates for two. For the Trojans, that gives her 20. 20 here in the second half. 20 points for Abby John, who's your leading scorer, and Markison for the Cougars is the leading scorer with 14. So Tingem with the drive, a little kiss off the glass for two. Nice drive and a little floater there for Tingem. Here goes Abby John again. Penetration, and that one is good for Abby John. That gives her 22 to lead all scorers here 51-37 with 9:40 left here in the second half. And the Barnesville boys game, 44-42. Barnesville's ahead with 3 minutes left. So looks like that's going to be an over the back on Severson. She is a 6'3 sophomore for the Cougars. This Cougars team, they got some height, they got some size, they got some length, and they got some youth on this team. There's four seniors. There are five sophomores and a couple juniors. So it is a young team with some athletic bigs. When you have some height, take advantage of that. It's the reason why they're 17-5 and 6-2 in their conference. So Lexi Hafe with the rebound. That one's a little off. Rebound to Severson. Gets it over to Smart. Smart bringing it up past half court line. Kicks it over to Tinjum. Tinjum looking up top for Brzezinski. Brzezinski over to Smart. Smart looking inside. See, she lobs it up to Severson. Great position by Severson there. Just a little short. Good pass in, though, to Severson underneath. So Abby John on the right wing. Seeing what the defense gives her. She's looking to penetrate, but we'll kick it out over to Pana. Pana from the wing for three. That one is good. That gives Macy Pana her first points of the game. She's got three. And with 8:20 left here in the second half, Trojans 54, Cougars 37. Good little rebound there, drive by Engelstad, just a little off. So, Pana kick in to Haft as Pana cuts to the basket. Great pass by Haft, and she left that layup just a little bit short, but good unselfish play by Haft, waiting patiently for Pana to cut to the basket. And Pana just not quite able to finish there. So that basket is good for the Cougars. Sarah Brzezinski. So the basket's good. She'll go to the free throw line to shoot one. That falls on Auburn Hens, her first team's fourth. So we got Frederick. We have Fallingstead, and we have Kennedy Gray checking in for the Trojans. So 7:48 here left in the second half. Lexi Hick with the rebound. 15-point lead for the Trojans, 55-39. Cassette over to Frederick. Frederick looking to drive, kicks it up to Haft. Haft with the dribble, kicks it over to Kennedy Gray. Kennedy Gray looking to go all the way to the basket. Severson was just a little out of position there to go up for the block. She's going to, Kennedy Gray is going to draw the foul on number 22, Elena Severson. That will be her third, team's fifth. So Kennedy Gray goes to the free throw line for the Trojans for two. Her first one is short. Kennedy Gray with 4 points tonight for the Trojans. Her second of two free throws. That one's off. Rebound to Engel. Engel over to Severson on the wing. Tinjum cutting. It looks like Cassette is going to get a foul called, and they're trying to knock the ball away from Severson. She gets her arm. Ref was right next to it. Calls a foul. So that is her second, team's fifth. So as of right now, we have more fouls for both teams in the second half than we did in the first half. So eventually we'll probably get to the bonus, unlike the first half, which we did not see any team shoot the bonus. So Cassette knocks the ball away from number five, Brzezinski. She tries to corral the loose ball and fumbles it out of bounds. So it'll go over to the Trojans with 7:08 left here in the second half. Trojans 54, Cougars 39. Pana looking to inbound, looking for a cutting. Ava Fallingstead to post up, but wasn't there. Gets it over to Cassette. Cassette to Gray. Gray over to Frederick on the baseline. To Cassette, good kick in to Ava Fallingstead. Right, great penetration there by Cassette. And Ava Fallingstead on that block. Gets the pass for the easy two. Good unselfish play there for the Trojans. So nice little drive there by number five, Sarah Brzezinski, for the Cougars. Oh, 15-point lead here for the Trojans with 6:30 left in the second half. So Frederick with the drive. Set kicks down to Fallingstead. Over to Frederick. Up to Cassette. Kennedy looked to back cut. She cuts back out into the corner. Kicks it up to Frederick. Frederick at the top. Kennedy Gray looking to drive. That one gets knocked away. We'll stay with the Trojans with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. And there's 1 minute left in the Trojans game versus the Rebels. It's 45-45. So again, we'll keep you posted on that score. So 2 seconds on the shot clock. That one's going to be blocked by Tinjum. That'll be turnover on the Trojans as they had 4 seconds left on the shot clock on that inbounds play. And they got a shot off, but it was blocked, which just means it's a turnover for the Trojans. So under 6 minutes left here in the second half. The Cougars set up in their offense. Will Severson at the top. Kicks it over to Smart. Smart for a three. That one's short. Good position there by Lexi Haft on the rebound. So Cassette down below to Gray, looking to penetrate over into Fallingstead, who's in her spot underneath the basket there. Great pass. Right play as Ava Fallingstead draws the foul. And Alex Tinjum with her first foul, team sixth. But Ava Fallingstead will go to the free throw line for two. Her first one is up and good. That gives Ava, I believe, 15 for the Trojans tonight. She's got a lot of great baskets right around with just unselfish play by the Trojans, looking for her inside, whether it's a lob pass or penetration, and getting her ball on her spot on the block where she is so deadly, right around the basket. So she misses her second, 57-41, 5:30 left here in the second half. Oh, Markson in the corner. Markson looking to drive. She's going to draw the foul, go to the free throw line to shoot two for the Cougars. So that is Kennedy Gray's second foul, team sixth, as Isabel Markison, 5'6", senior, goes to the free throw line for two for the Cougars. First one is in and out. Isabel Markison, the leading scorer for the Cougars with 14 points tonight. She's done a little bit of both inside and outside scoring. So that one again, in and out for Markison. Oh, good steal by number five, Sarah Brzezinski. 2 points for the Cougars. So Cassette brings the ball across the timeline. Gets it over to Haft. Haft over to Frederick. Frederick looking to drive. Kicks it out to Ava Fallingstead. Ava Fallingstead's going to drive. Lexi Haft with a 15-footer. That one is good. Nice pass by Ava to Lexi Haft from about 15 for two. Nothing but net. 16-point lead for the Trojans with 4:45 left here in the second half. Oh. We got a travel on number five, Sarah Brzezinski, as she was trying to get around her defender and took one extra step. So it gets called for the travel. So turnover on the Cougars. So again, we will keep you posted on the score from DGF for the boys as soon as I get a quick message from activities director Aaron Schindler. So we'll keep you posted on that one. So Ava Fallingstead with good position underneath, but Severson, again, 6'3 sophomore, had good position on Fallingstead, and Ava had a tough time getting it over her. So turnover on the Cougars. And I do have a quick update. The Barnesville boys are down 47-45 with 0.4 seconds left, and it's our ball based on what activities director Aaron Schindler is telling me. So they're down two with 0.4. So I'll get you that score as soon as I can, as soon as I get it back. So that Trojan foul will be on Annika Cassette. That will be her third, team seventh, which means the Cougars will be going to the free throw line for the bonus. So going to the free throw line for the Cougars is Engelstead, 5'11 junior. One's long. Lexi Hafe with another rebound. She's done a great job on the boards tonight. She, both her and Fallingstead, don't quite have the height advantage that the Cougars do, but they've done a nice job on box outs and getting to those rebounds. And again, you get a team that's got 3, 4, even 5 inches on some of the players. You got to do a good job on keeping your defender on your back when shots go up and rebounds. And so both Ava and Lexi Haft have done a nice job boxing out tonight. So 3:23 left here in the second half. Markson bringing it up for the Cougars, and she goes all the way for two. And as of right now, it looks like the Barnesville boys lost by two, 47-45 to DGF. So they do have one more conference game on Friday against Holly. So just because they didn't win tonight doesn't mean that they still can't win the conference. It's just going to come down to, I think, three teams. I think DGF, now that they got that win tonight, Pelican Rapids and Barnesville. So should be interesting to see how things play out with the last conference game. It'll be a great game right here at home. So for those of you that can make it here on Friday night for that last conference home game before section start, the Barnesville boys will be on the road all next week. I believe they go to Border West, which is down in Wheaton. And then on Friday next week, they go up to East Grand Forks to finish the season. So last home regular season game will be next Friday against Holly. And again, that could be for a share of the conference, which would be outstanding for the boys since it hasn't happened for a couple decades. So, all right, anyways, enough about the boys. That game is over. This game is still going on. And so got a foul here on Isabella Snowball. That's her first, team eighth. Team's eighth foul. Going to the free throw line for the Cougars is number 12, Morgan Engel, to shoot two. Makes her first. She has 9 for the Cougars tonight. Her second free throw is up. That one's in and out. Rebound to Fallingstead. So Cassette bringing it up. Gets it down to, good jump by Kennedy Gray there to make sure it didn't go out of bounds. So Trojans got a 14-point lead here with 2:35 left in the game. And we'll see how they run their offense here with a 14-point lead. So top of the key to Frederick. Frederick over to Gray. We got 13 seconds left. Gray tried to get it in to Fallingstead, and Severson knocked that one away on the entry pass. And so Kennedy Gray picks up a foul quite a ways away from the basket. That's going to be her third, team's ninth. So this will be the last bonus for the Cougars as Morgan Engel goes to shoot the 1-1 for them. She knocks the first one down. That gives Morgan Engel 10. So you have two players in double figures for the Cougars, Markison and Engel. Markison with 16 and Engel now with 11 for the Cougars. So it's a 12-point game with 2:20 left here in the second half. So Cassette over to Gray. Gray up top to Fallingstead. Fallingstead over to Cassette. Set up to Frederick. Back over to Cassette. So looking inside, Snowball's got position, but back over to Gray. 13 seconds left on the shot clock. So Cassette looking to drive. Gets the ball knocked away by Morgan Smart. Got 1:50 left here. 12-point game, Trojans over the Cougars. Oh, Cougars looking inside. Morgan Engel had nice position there and just couldn't quite finish. So we're gonna have a stoppage of play as Markison, I think she might have got hit in the face as her and a Trojan were going for the rebound. And she might have, trainer Shane comes out with a towel. So it looks like she might have got hit in the mouth. And so she will half to exit the game, as Markison is their leading scorer here for the Cougars. So hope she is okay. We'll give you an update on her once we find out. So we'll go back over to the Trojans as the stoppage in play was from the referees. So 1:40 left here in the second half. Abby John checks back in for the game. So she's got on the right wing over to Snowball. Snowball looking over to John. John with it on the right wing. Looking inside to Snowball. That one's not quite there. Engelstad with good defensive position there gets the steal. So again, 12-point game. Good inside pass there to Engelstad. Engelstad has three here for the Cougars, and it is a 10-point game for most of the second half. It's been a double-figure lead, at least in the second part of the second half for the Trojans. So Cougars still hanging around. So Abby John kicks it over to Frederick. Frederick over to Gray, Gray to Snowball. Snowball back over to Frederick on the wing. Tingem tries to steal it, looks inside to Ava. Ava kicks it back out with 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Frederick with the jump shot, that one's a little short. Good kickback, 2 seconds on the shot clock, and the shot clock will run out. So good hustle there by the Trojans. They just couldn't quite get the shot off. So 32.7 seconds left here in the game with a 10-point lead for the Trojans. Leading scorer for the Trojans is Abby John with 22. Oh, Cougars running their offense. Tingem on the right wing. She's open for three, and that one's good. Alex Tingem with 12 tonight. That gives three players for the Cougars in double figures. Tingem with 12. Engel with 11, and Brzezinski with 11. And I believe when Markison went out with the injury, I believe she had 14 points. So you had four players for the Cougars in double figures tonight. But they just came up a little bit short tonight here at the Barnesville Sports Arena with the Trojans pulling this one out. Trojans 60, Ada Borup Cougars 53. Your leading scorer for both teams tonight, Abby John with 22. She had a bulk of her points in the first half. I think she had 16 or 18 in the first half. Finishes with 22 to lead all scorers. Ava Fallingstead with 15 for the Trojans. So, and again, just to give you a quick update, if you just joined us, the Barnesville boys lose by 2 at DGF tonight. And so, again, this will, I believe they're still with one more game. They'll have an opportunity to at least have a share of the conference if they can win on Friday versus Hawley. And again, that's the last conference game, last home game, and then the last conference game, as they'll have two games next week, one against Border West down in Wheaton, and then next Friday, their last game before section start will be at East Grand Forks. So we encourage you to, if you can, come out to the Barnesville Sports Arena on Friday to support the boys' basketball team in their quest to win, or at least share the conference title. But again, tonight's about the girls. The girls really came out, I thought, strong from the beginning from the offensive standpoint of they were pushing the ball, they were getting rebounds. Abby John was leading the fast break, and if she wasn't getting some easy baskets, there was usually a 3-on-2, and the Trojans, I think, in the first half, I believe they had 33. At least half those points were off a transition, and that's the name of the game for the Lady Trojans. And what Coach Baumstead wants out of the girls is, you know, if it's there, let's try to get some fast break and easy baskets. If not, they were smart enough to bring it back out, run their offense, and I thought they did an excellent job tonight. And something I haven't seen a lot from the Lady Trojans is their inside game when they were definitely outsized from the Cougars versus the Trojans. I mean, you have 5'11", 6'3", 5'11", 6'1", and 5'10" for the Cougars. And if you look at the Trojans, we have one, Ashley Manaville is 5'10", Ava Fallingstead and Lexi Haft, who are your posts. One is 5'9", and then 5'8". And so you talk about, you know, the height advantage that the Cougars had with over the Trojans tonight. The Barnesville was able to do a nice job of getting some high-low action from the top of the key, whether it was Lexi Haft, Kennedy Gray, Sophia Frederick, looking inside to Ava Fallingstead. They had a hard time at the beginning of the game, but they were able to kind of get a nice flow there late in the first half and then all that second half with a high-low game. And I tell you what, if that's something that you can do, Ava Fallingstead, 9 out of 10 times, is going to finish the basket around the basket. And so I think it's a great thing to see as Lady Trojans are going into sections with maybe a little bit of different offense to show to some teams, regardless if you have size on them or not. It was a good thing to see from the Lady Trojans tonight. So, again, the Lady Trojans over the Cougars tonight by 7, 60-53. We hope you enjoyed the broadcast. I'm going to give one quick shout-out here for our sponsors. Again, we didn't get a chance to thank our sponsors we didn't have a lot of timeouts or stoppages in play. So we'll thank our sponsors one more time that allow us to bring you this game, to live stream it into your homes. So we thank Lee's Electric, Ratzo's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Ball Green Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnesville Grocery, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. So we hope you enjoyed tonight's broadcast. And as always, go Trojans. What's up, buddy?
Yeah, you too.